Bump at my inner corner after Asian epicanthoplasty, 3 months post-op. I've had my eyelid surgery, double eyelid surgery and epicanthoplasty, 3 months ago. Healing went well. Yesterday, I noticed a bump next to my inner corners, and it hurts a little bit. I also added a photo to show how it looks like. Hope that somebody can help me, because I just don't know what to do.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a photo and stated in your question that you had Asian eyelid surgery with epicanthoplasty performed approximately 3 months ago. And you stated that everything was healing well and that you've noticed that there is a bump in the lower eyelid and you're seeking some guidance as to what this situation is about. Well, I could certainly give you an opinion. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. This means that when I completed first a residency in ophthalmology or eye surgery, I went on to do advanced training in cosmetic and reconstructive surgery of the eyelids. I've been in practice mostly in cosmetic surgery in the past 20-plus years in Manhattan and Long Island, and Asian eyelid surgery has been a significant part of my practice. So I'm quite familiar with the procedures you underwent, and certainly the ophthalmology background can help you with this issue related to the eyelid. So basically, when I look at your photo, and of course with the without a physical examination, I can just make a reasonable attempt to give you some guidance of what I think it is. But essentially, it looks like the procedure of eyelid surgery and the bump and the red spot that you have are not necessarily directly related. In other words, where the incisions are typically made for either upper eyelid surgery or epicanthoplasty, the location of this bump is pretty far away from those incisions. So if the thought is maybe that there was a suture that remained or there was a retained dissolving stitch or something like that related to that, I think it's relatively unlikely. I would suggest that essentially what you're dealing with is an area of inflammation at the base of an eyelash. And that typically is related to a blockage of an oil gland called a gland of Zeis. And like adolescent or teenage acne, the oily secretion as well as the process of exfoliation could essentially be affecting the drainage of that gland and result in a blockage. This leads into an inflammation, typically referred to as a hordeolum or external hordeolum, and commonly referred to as a stye. Now, generally, the treatment for something like this is pretty conservative. Warm compresses, and if that does not get better, then you put on antibiotics. Now, the reason for the warm compresses is that essentially is to liquefy the thicker oily secretions so that they drain more easily. Now, as far as what could have stimulated this to happen, which is maybe indirectly related to the surgery, well, I have a couple of thoughts and they may apply to you. One is that if the eyes feel dry at all, or if you're in an environment where your eyes are very dry, the reaction is often to secrete more tears, and for the glands that generate the lipid or the oil layer of the tear film to increase in activity. Now that can mean that similarly to the teenage acne, you're basically blocking the gland because of the increased production, which means you want to diminish the stimulus for that production, and that would be just lubricating the eyes with artificial tears. Now, if that's not the case, another case scenario could be that some patients will continue to use antibiotic ointment, although the surgery was long behind, in fear of there being potential for infection, and because they like maybe the moist feeling of the antibiotic ointment on the skin and the surface of the eye. Now, unfortunately, the vehicle or the petrolatum, like Vaseline, that the antibiotic is in, can also block the openings of these glands, or the glands of Zeis, or the sweat glands. So if you're doing that, then it's advisable to stop. I would say that, again, conservative treatment, warm compresses, and it seems it's probably most likely unrelated directly. You can treat conservatively. If this does not resolve, bring this to the attention to an ophthalmologist. But I think that that most likely this will spontaneously improve. Once again, it's most likely external hordeolum or hordeolum and or Stye, and that it should respond to warm compresses. And of course, continue your follow-up with your doctor related to your cosmetic eyelid surgery. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.